B.Grimm has survived here in Thailand. It's gone through many political crises, economic turmoils. What is it about the employees, the people working within the company, that's made it so resilient all these years?
I have been asking the same. I've been asking those who have been working a long time with the company. And the main point they always say that they really think that we are a compassionate company. And that in our company you can live without politics. And then there is a great help. It's like in Thailand they call it pinong. So it's like a family. So people like to help each other. Instead of your neighbor is your fiercest competitor, your neighbor is your best friend. So here everybody tries to help each other. You can see it very clearly at B.Grimm Power. And sometimes we have these projects that have been done. People from all kind of departments, they come to help each other. And we always have the weekly meetings with all departments together about business development, project development, and operation of the companies. And they all come together to help each other with ideas and with actions. So I think this has been the reason why we keep on going. There's a great affection for each other and great support for each other.
B.Grimm is very well entrenched here in Thailand. You're in practically almost every aspect of business here in the country. You're in power generation, real estate, transport, infrastructure, healthcare, education, lifestyle. Any new businesses you want to get into?
We just got into a new business. We're building a university together at the premises of the University of the Thai Chamber of Commerce. And it's a joint venture with Harbour Space, which is a new university in Spain. And what is so important and interesting about that is now the whole world wants to go digital. And in Thailand, there are many people who want to become digital entrepreneurs. But they lack the digital knowledge, so they're not deep enough. And they lack entrepreneurship. So this is what this university teaches. In what way? Not with tenured professors. They have a roster of 1,800 of the world's best experts in special fields. And they're willing to give their time to the students. Whilst the students, they come with a project and work on that project, either because the company send them or they want to become an entrepreneur. And these professors or lecturers, they help them to make it happen. So when they have their degree, they will have a project at hand, they can run it as a company. So I think this is a contribution we can make to Thailand to bring this here. And SEG, biggest Thai industrial company, they're already enthusiastic about it. And then some of the other companies already enthusiastic about it, they want to do that. And the University of the Thai Chamber of Commerce, they're completely thrilled. And Harbour Space said they would never expect that we have such competent people and it would work so easily, so well. So this is our latest project, building a university.
Your eyes light up when you talk about these new projects. It gets you excited.
Yes, yes, I do. Yes, they are very exciting. And I think every single thing is really good for Thailand. So it's just, again, and I think excitement only comes through that, not through figures.
Mm. You talked about the digital age.
Yes.
How does a 141-year-old company like B.Grimm survive and stay relevant in this age?
I think this is an excellent question. And I think there's only one reason, which I think applies to all companies who endure, is you have to be always modern. So be true to your past, and at the same time always have the latest technologies applied in your business.
So be ready for disruption.
Yes, disruption is actually a word that is used now, but I think in 100 years ago there was much bigger disruption than today. I think it's kind of the disruption today compared to when you started to fly, when you started to drive, when you started to make a phone call, when you started to make a telex. I mean, that really revolutionized the world in terms of communication. The internet is a kind of a further step, you get knowledge better, but what a change was that. So I think actually we are all used to these kind of new things, only now they come so fast that the business, they have to adjust much faster. We have our own digital business, we bring this digital university here, and so we try to make sure that we we are continuing being modern.
Hi, I'm Christine Tan, and thanks for watching Managing Asia. Do check out more of our videos by clicking on the boxes on the screen. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more from CNBC International. Thanks for watching.